Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, I'm gonna answer your questions for the new audience app experience. Let's do it. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. I released a video talking about the new app experience where it introduced audiences. So now you can have multiple audiences per app and then assign that to different access lists, which is awesome. But you had a ton of questions. There were a lot of questions in the comments section. I also had some other questions on the live streams, other questions I had in just general conversation. So there were a couple of main themes, and so I want to answer them here. So enough of all this talking. You know, we like to do it here in Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine. So the first thing I'm going to highlight here, when we go to the app, people were like, oh, we've set up these audiences and everything's great, but wait a second, everybody can see everything. What's going on here? The answer here is if they are a member of the workspace, and I don't mean from a role level. So if they're in the actual workspace, they will see everything. If we go back to the actual workspace, and if we go into update an app and we go to the audience tab where it sees the list of which groups or users have access to this audience, you'll notice that workspace users are just listed there, and they're listed there for each audience, and you can't remove it. By default, that is just there. So if they're listed as either a viewer, contributor, member, or admin, they're going to see all of the audiences. So if you want them to be restricted by a certain audience, make sure they are not a member of the actual workspace. That caused some confusion. The audiences are meant for just distribution and consumption through the app only. The next item that we saw here, I'm going to go back to content and I'm going to add another piece of content. So I'm going to say another report and let's add it. Everything's great. And then we're going to update the app. Sweet. But the problem here is that when we go to the actual app, it's not listed. What's the deal? I added the piece of content to the app. The problem here is that when you add a new piece of content to an app, it's hidden by default. So it's not going to show up. So you've got to explicitly unhide it inside of the app. Let me show you. Let's go back to the workspace, update app. And if we go to the audience tab, you'll see that another report here is hidden. There's this little eye icon with a slash in it. If I select that, then the report becomes available. You may be thinking here also like, well, I want help at the bottom, but I can't order this. You got to go back to content and we got to move it back up. Oh, it got added there. I don't want it there. I want it above. There we go. Careful with your clicks, everyone. So with it in the right location, if we go back to audiences, you'll see that it's listed here appropriately. And then if you want to add it to the other one, you can. Otherwise, it's still hidden. And then go ahead and update the app. Another item that came up in some conversations and in the comments as well was kind of this confusion of if you're assigned to multiple audiences, you're added in one and then added in another, which one wins? And the answer is all of them. And so you can see here that by default, I'm a workspace user. So I see all of the audiences and you can click between them to see what they look like. And then it also adds this all item, which will show you every single item that's in the list. And that's just there to help you easily navigate that content instead of having to figure out which audience is it a part of. Everything's just there in one spot, which is awesome. Another item that came up in the comments and it came up in a separate conversation was what happened to save a copy? This was a feature that was there in the old app experience, but it's not there right now in the new app experience. To show you what I'm talking about, let me go to the old app experience and then we go to file. You have this option to save a copy. So what this allows you to do is to actually save a copy to your My Workspace and then just kind of customize it a little bit, make it your own, which is a nice feature that a lot of people like. When we go to the new app experience, you'll notice that it's not there. Some people have been using this feature and they want to know what's up. And the answer is right now in from a preview state of it, it's just not there. This should become available as it comes closer to general availability. Hang tight. It'll be back. And then the last item I want to kind of highlight on is there was a lot of different comments around this. And this was this concept of how do I hide specific pages from a given report within an audience experience? So if we look at overview and then this testing another page, and you know, I don't want to show this testing another page. So if we go back into the workspace, so within the audience, all I can do is I can hide or show a given report, but within that report, I can't do that within a page. Or it could be the concept of, look, I hid the page in the report, but maybe I want to show it for this specific audience. So there's a lot of different combinations that kind of come into this question. And the truth of the matter is there is not a concept of page level security with inside of Power BI today. So it's defined at the report and or the app in Workspace, right? I did see some comments of people saying that I just want to hide it. I don't care if they can still get to the page. Just from a navigation perspective, I don't want them to see that. And unfortunately, that's not necessarily part of it either. Now, you could technically hide the page in the report and then have some navigation within the main page of the report, but you're not going to be able to see that or unhide it from an audience experience with inside of the app. So you could kind of get around that, but you have to have some custom navigation with inside of the report itself. It's not going to be driven by the app. The one area where I saw that this does potentially cause a problem is in the terms of paginated reports. So if you have a sub report from a paginated perspective, you don't want to show that sub report. The challenge right now with the app experience is if you hide the sub report, it breaks the main paginated report. We'll have to stay tuned to see if that gets resolved. So if you are hitting that problem, be sure to open a support ticket and let the folks know that that is a feedback item that you want. All right, I want to hand this over to you. Thank you for all the questions that you've had. Keep them coming. Put more in the comments if you'd like. Keep the feedback coming on the app experience. I know the Power BI team wants to make this as effective as possible for you. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.